Welcome to the 2023 installment of 32 and 32 season previews. I'm Dan Rosen, along with Amelie Benjamin, and we're going to touch on everything from off-season moves and playoff outlook to fantasy prep with Anna Dua a little later. And today, we're taking a look at everything Montreal Canadiens. Amelie, the Montreal Canadiens are following a path. They're following a path that they told everybody that they were going to be on, right? It's going to be long. It's going to be tough. It's going to be painful at times. We saw it last year. But then we also saw so many injuries that really hurt their chances to take big steps last year. So that really was a problem for them. But otherwise, I think they're where they figured they would be.
Yeah, I mean, there's no one who's confused about what's happening right in Montreal. It is a rebuild. And you're right, last season was really tough. I mean, the number of guys who were in the press box injured was unbelievable. So you're looking at these guys to come back, and hopefully that will help these young players take steps. I mean, I think we're looking to see more from Caulfield. We're looking to see more from Slavkovsky. I mean, these are guys who are young, who have all the talent in the world, and who will be given every chance be better.
Right. And Cole Caulfield and Juraj Slavkovsky are two of those guys that spent a lot of time in the press box with injuries. Caulfield had 26 goals in 46 games. Then he had the shoulder injury and he was out for the season. Slavkovsky, you know, number one pick in the draft, really didn't get his feet wet in the NHL enough because of injuries. They added Alex Newhook. It's an addition I like. Alex Newhook comes from Colorado. He was playing down the lineup there because, well, I mean, they're loaded. Okay. So that's number one. Here in Montreal now, with the addition, he's going to get an opportunity to play a bigger role, and I think he can do that. And he's a guy who's won the Stanley Cup as well. So I like that addition from Newhook. The loss is nothing really crazy. Joel Edmondson, he's gone, traded to Washington. Jonathan Drouin signed with Colorado. Denis Kurianov signed with Nashville. But I like the addition of Newhook to be a part of that. Like, he's right in that age group, too, of a lot of their players.
And to me, something that's also interesting is not only are the players looking at, getting minutes, increasing their time, figuring out what it means to be in the NHL, so is their coach.
Yeah.
I mean, you have a coach in Martin St-Louis who is still figuring his way out in the NHL. You know, he's not a guy who came in with a lot of experience coaching, so I think sort of both of the players and the coach growing in tandem this year, I think this could be a really big development year sort of all over this organization.
This year, the big question is, will Marty St. Louis, it's not a question, he will be holding them accountable for their mistakes. But how are guys like Caulfield, like Kirby Dach, like Juraj Slavkovsky, even Nick Suzuki, the captain of this team, and many of their young defensemen, Caden Gooley, Justin Barron among them, how will those players handle now being held accountable for their mistakes? Because they have to take the next step. They have to move forward in this rebuild. It's a huge year for the Canadiens.
Absolutely, and it's something we've seen, say, the Buffalo Sabres go through, is you get to that point where you need to be accountable, and we've seen them sort of get there. And I think as the season goes on, you know, they're not going to be held accountable necessarily when you start off in October,
right.
But I think as you see month by month by month go on, and if this season goes according to plan and you don't have half the team in the press box, I think you'll see that from them. I think you'll see St. Louis holding them accountable. I think you'll see more responsibility on these guys. And I think they're going to have some big steps in their development.
It's going to be huge for them this season. Look, Anna, we'll bring you in here. From a fantasy perspective, there's so many ways you can go because there's so much potential here with the Montreal Canadiens. Which way are you looking right now?
I'm looking at Slavkovsky right now, guys, just because we really didn't get to see much of him. You mentioned that earlier, limited to just 39 games last season for the Canadiens. Drafted first overall in 2022. I want to see what a full season of him looks like in the NHL because he's playing with some really talented young players. Suzuki, Kirby Dach, Cole Caulfield, and if he's in that top six for the Canadiens, we really don't know what his potential is yet, so it's worth taking a flyer on him in most fantasy drafts, I think, this year.
And has Kirby Dach taken a step in terms of a fantasy perspective? Because it didn't go that well for him in Chicago. He gets traded, bigger role here now in Montreal, and like you talked about, he could play with Slavkovsky, he could play with Caulfield. There's a number of different options there, too, for Kirby Dach.
He absolutely could, and that's one benefit for the Montreal Canadiens, a little bit of a positive spin, is these young guys have so much opportunity to find their own and play their own game and fit into various roles within this team because they don't have that much depth. So you see Kirby Dach having this bigger role, and I think it's going to benefit him. It's all about staying healthy. If they can find some momentum, lock in a top six for the second half of the year, I think all of these guys that we just mentioned, their production is going to go way up come springtime.
All right, I think I know where we're all going to go here, but Anna, we'll start with you. Playoff prediction for the Montreal Canadiens.
Soon. Not this year, but soon.
Emily?
I mean, no, but I have a question about Soon. I mean, this is a killer division. So I think it's going to be really hard for this team, even as talented as it is, even as much potential as it has, to find a way to eventually break into that playoff picture.
But I agree with Anna when she said soon. What's soon? Soon's a relative term. Is it next season? Is it two seasons? Is it three seasons from now? Because you're right. You got other teams in this division. Toronto's still right there. Tampa's still right there. Florida went to the Stanley Cup final last year. Buffalo's pushing. Detroit's pushing. Ottawa's pushing, right? So, like, there's teams in this division right now that are going to make it. And by the way, the team that set records last year, the Boston Bruins.
I was going to call you on it if you didn't
mention
them.
You didn't have to call me on it. They're there, too. But no. Not this season for the Montreal Canadiens, not a playoff team. We go 3 for 3 on that prediction here. We'll see if we go 3 for 3 at the end of the year. I'm pretty sure we will. Thanks for joining us. And a reminder that NHL.com is providing in-depth roster, prospect, and fantasy analysis for each of the league's 32 teams every single day from August 1st through September 1st. And of course, you can find us right here on NHL.com and NHL YouTube as we continue to break it all down. We'll see you next time on 32 and 32.